Hey everyone, welcome back to the second installment of Ask LSV here on channelfirewall.com. Our first question today comes from Josh, and it's actually a couple of questions. He has a few questions about black-white tokens, more specifically some of the card choices that people seem to be making. Let's take a look. Josh asks, everyone's playing Identity Crisis now, but why is it better in head games? Does the extra mana really not make that much of a difference? Well, it's an interesting question, and one I've actually come on both sides of. I did advocate Identity Crisis in some of my previews, but I'm still not 100% sure that it is, in fact, the right choice. Head games does cost one less mana, and that's a pretty big deal, especially since the difference between 5 and 6 can mean the difference of a few turns in casting it. I'm not sure yet exactly which one would be better. I think using Crisis for now is probably best, especially since with Windbrisk, it doesn't really matter how much mana it costs. In general, that's what people have been using, and part of that's probably because it's a new card. But I think time will tell better, but for now I'd stick with Identity Crisis. Next part of his question involves Path to Exile and Terror. He asks, everyone's also playing Path to Exile now, but originally you had Terror's main deck with Paths in the sideboard. Which one's better? I still like Terror's main and Paths sideboard. I wouldn't play any Path's main until it already played four Terrors, and I don't think you really need more than that anyway. Paths in the sideboard are fine because they get rid of Doran or Tide Hollow Sculler or other black creatures you can't actually use Terror on. Demigod of Revenge, Chameleon Colossus since it's pro-black. But overall, I think that Terror is going to be a lot better. You really don't want to give them a land. It is a 2-for-1, and you generally try to avoid that. I think everyone's playing Path because maybe the first deck list that did well at a PTQ played the Paths instead of the Terrors, and everyone's just copying them. The tricky part is they're so close that you could be playing Paths and not really realize how much worse they are than Terrors, since the effect is mostly the same. But I think the difference will add up, and I definitely would recommend playing Terror over Path. Lastly, he's got a lot of questions about Black-White, but I guess that makes sense. He asked my opinion on Zealous Persecution, since everyone seems to be playing the main deck now. Well, I think the first people to be playing the main deck, it was a good choice. It's getting to the point where since everyone's doing it, people can play around it better, and people are going to build their decks to adapt to it. I'm not sure if Zealous Persecution is really a strict 4 of main deck, especially since in a long game, Glorious Anthem and Ajani will end up being more important. Overall, I'm interested to see how Black-White ends up, since there are a lot of these really close choices and a lot of cards that no one's really sure what's better. I can give my opinion now, but after more playtesting, who knows? All right, let's get to our next question here. Next questions are actually from Derek. he's actually playing today at the regionals I'm at, because we're here at the Superstar store in San Jose. And he had some questions before the event about Turbofog, since that's the new breakout deck of the format. For those of you who don't know about it, even though it's been featured pretty prominently, it's got 4 Howling Mine, 4 Font of Mythos, and 4 Jace Bellerin. So basically 12 Howling Mine effects, and then a bunch of fogs. Cryptic Commands of Fog, Angel Song, Holy Day, Batwing Broom, Pollen Lullaby. And the idea is you draw enough cards every turn that you're drawing a fog every turn, and you just lock out their attack step and eventually deck them with either Jace or the fact that they draw first off all the Howling Mine effects. It's a pretty funny deck, and Derek wanted to know if it's a good choice and why it got so popular all of a sudden. It burst on the scene when it won a Japanese regional tournament, and although the list looked a little rough, like playing Batwing Broom instead of Angel Song, which doesn't make too much sense to me, part of the reason it's popular is both because it's novel, it's new, everyone, you know, takes a look at this really cool looking deck and wants to play it, and because it's actually got a legitimately good matchup if people aren't ready for it. For example, Black-White Tokens, the most popular deck, and then Green-White Tokens, and then Bant, all these decks can't beat Turbofog unless they devote sideboard slots, and I think everyone's idea was that no one would do that. The deck broke out late enough that I think it might be possible for people to avoid it, since, in general, I don't think a lot of people are aware that the deck will be so popular, because I predict it's going to be relatively popular at regionals. Pretty dedicated sideboard slots can really hurt the strategy, but if no one's ready for it, just go ahead and fog away. And that's what Derek's plan is today. He's just going to be, you know, hoping that no one has really any answers, which most main decks don't and most sideboards don't, and just keep fogging. He asks, what's good against it if people were to try and hate it out? Well, there are a few things, a few answers. I think the best solution for Black-White Tokens is actually Everlasting Torment, which is kind of funny because that's a card red decks side in against Black-White Tokens. See, Everlasting Torment says damage can't be prevented. And, well, all the fogs prevent damage. Except for Cryptic Command, but they only get four of those. So, with an Everlasting Torment out, Angel Song, Holy Day, Batwing Broom, they don't do anything. Paul Lullaby, all of that. If you can stick an Everlasting Torment, the fog deck actually just loses almost on the spot. Their only solution is to bounce it with like Cryptic Command, then counter it on the way back down. But they usually don't have time to do all that. One neat thing is that because of all their Howling Mines, you're also going to probably draw into your sideboard cards, since they're making you draw so many cards. For decks that aren't playing black, your options are a little more limited. The Fairies deck in general is quite good against it, since just countering their spells and playing Mistbind Clicks ought to be enough. And speaking of decks that are good against Turbofog, Sanity Grinding, that's probably as close to a buy as you can get for grinding. Sure, they could ruin Halo Sanity Grinding itself, but you've got four Boomerangs, four Cryptic Commands, and all the Howling Mines do is fuel your Shell Dock Isles. I suspect that Sanity Grinding can't lose to Turbofog unless something pretty drastic happens. Turbofog might be a better choice against the field, but if you're the grinding deck and you play against Turbofog, it's pretty good news. All right, well, that wraps up our questions for today. A lot of questions about Standard, and I think people are going to start sending more questions about varied formats, but with regionals especially, Standard was on everyone's mind. And even though regionals by now is gone, we've got all these Standard PTQs to worry about. So make sure to go to the new form we made for Ask LSV on channelfireball.com, or where you can drop all your questions, and I'll either get to them in the forum or get to them in a video, of course, time permitting, if they end up being pretty popular, then I can't promise the turnaround time won't be more than a few days. Thanks for watching.